In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use LinkAssistant, the most effective link building and outreach management tool. Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Mary from SEO PowerSuite, the all-in-one toolkit that covers every aspect of SEO. Previously, I did tutorials about Rank Tracker, Website Auditor, and SEO SpyGlass, so this is kind of like the fourth and the last tutorial of this kind. And I left links to those videos in the description below, so if you're new to our software, this video series will help you get started with the tools. To start looking for link prospects, you need to install and start your LinkAssistant. After you open it, the tool will ask you to create your first project. The setup is super simple. All you need to do is to enter the domain that you would like to promote. You can choose your target country and language, and the search engine used by the app will be automatically customized based on the setup. You can also add the negative keywords to the topic block list if needed. The app will check each potential prospect's backlink profile to exclude the ones that have your negative keywords in referring anchor text. But again, these settings are optional. Now click Create. Please wait a few moments until the app gathers the initial prospect suggestions for your website. By default, that'll be the list of top 100 backlinks or your domain's competitors with the highest in link rank. You can always start a new search by clicking the Start a New Search button in the Search for Prospects module. The idea of LinkAssistant is to help you find your potential link partners. For that, the app uses different search methods, such as guest posting, reviews, top-ranking pages, similar websites, and more. Choose what type of link prospects you'd like LinkAssistant to look for. Pick any of the 6 predefined methods or set up a search of your own in the expert mode. Let's say you want to find blogs that allow guest articles. You should click the guest posting method, enter the seed keywords that best describe your niche, adjust the search engine if needed, and assign tags. Tags are optional, but they are very convenient for further management. Hit Find and the LinkAssistant tool will start searching for new partners. As soon as it finishes, you will get a list of potential partners along with their pages preview, contact details, domain and page in link rank showing link popularity, and organic traffic the domain gets. If you see that the add sign is green, that means the tool has found the contact. Click it, and the details tab will appear. At a glance, you will see the page's title and description to evaluate the content of the page, and of course, contact emails. Pay attention to domain in LinkRank and in LinkRank scores. These metrics have been introduced by our team as a substitution for Google PageRank, and they show the popularity and importance of a domain or a specific page. The higher the in LinkRank is, the more important this domain or this page is for Google. The results and the feed can also be sorted in a convenient order and filtered based on the freshness, traffic, or in LinkRank. You can also apply any filtering conditions to exclude the results you're not interested in. For instance, we can sort out the results by prospect info, prospect authority factor, indexing in search engines, social media popularity, and topic block list, because LinkAssistant allows us to block prospects if we want to do so. If you feel like a certain domain is irrelevant and you want to remove it from the list, click here and the prospect will be excluded. To manage your excluded domains, go to Preferences, Prospect Management, Excluded Prospect Domains. Here you can create a list of domains and subdomains that LinkAssistant shouldn't suggest to you as link prospects in the future. For instance, here you can add websites whose webmaster has asked you not to contact them with link requests again. If you'd rather work with a good old spreadsheet view, you can switch to table view at the top right. The workspace will list all the same search results in a table instead of a feed with the metrics in the columns next to each. You can move, add, or remove any column. To add or remove a column, click the Edit Visible Columns button and choose any factor you'd like to add. As you can see, there are plenty of factors to choose from. Titles, meta descriptions, Facebook likes and shares, Pinterest bookmarks, and many others. check the box next to the necessary factor that you would like to appear in the table, or uncheck it if you want to remove it. Click OK, and there you go. If you find some relevant prospects and want to start the outreach process, select a prospect, click the Move to Prospects button, and it will be added to the main prospects dashboard. As you can see, the tool has added not only the prospect's URL, but also title, meta description, the prospect's email, and other information. Before you contact website owners with a proposal, you should set up your email account first. LinkAssistant has an inbuilt mailing module to let you reach out to prospects right in app, in a few clicks, and keep all the correspondence in one place. To connect your email account, go to the email module and click on the Settings button. Now you'll need to specify the sender name and enter your email address and password. Optionally, you can configure advanced settings in the next steps if you tick the box. You may need that for a custom email address that have in common server, port, security settings to connect to third-party apps. In step 2, you need to enter the incoming mail settings, including server, port, username and password, and security settings. Please mind that the software doesn't support IMAP, so to connect an email account, you need to make sure that POP is enabled in its settings directly. If you are using a standard Gmail account, this can be done in General Account Settings, in Forwarding, and POP IMAP section. In step 3, you will be asked to specify the outgoing mail settings. Step 4 will enable you to adjust the settings that should be used to manage messages on your server. This dashboard works the same way as Microsoft Outlook or any other email client, so you can keep your emails here, receive responses, and send back your answers. In other words, do all the communication with your partners within the LinkAssistant tool. Once the setup is done, you can start sending emails to your potential prospects. To do that, just select them in your project workspace, click Email, and this will open up a predefined email template that you may use. If you click here, you will see a drop-down menu with a number of predefined email templates that you can use for common situations. The templates include pre-written text for rather standard requests like guest posting inquiry or link removal requests and others, with your data being applied automatically. You can edit, clone, remove any template, or create your own ones. Just pay attention that email templates are using different variables that stand for such information as backlink partners, domain partners, backlink page. So if you want to use these variables, make sure that they are used properly. When you are ready, hit the Send button. All the emails sent and received will be visible in the email module. When building backlinks, it is important to specify the basics, so that your link partner knows exactly what you expect the future link to look like. Equally important is checking on backlinks once gained to make sure they are live and well set up. To do that, you need to create an anchor text in your project settings. Go to Preferences, Prospect Management, Anchor Settings. To specify new anchor settings, click Add. Specify the URL you want to promote, set the link type, as well as backlink anchor text and description. Now switch to the main dashboard, select Partners, right-click, choose the Change Anchor Text option, and then select one anchor tag from the list you want to assign to a certain partner. This way the partner will have the right anchor URL and anchor text. After you've got your first backlinks, check whether they were set up the way you wanted them to be. Double-click on any of your prospects to analyze the backlink you gained. Switch between the tabs to edit prospect and backlink data in 2 clicks. Pick one or several domains and hit Verify to update prospect data. Choose to scan only the current page. Click OK, and then LinkAssistant will start verifying these partners. Once done with the verification, add the verification past column to your workspace. Click on the columns header to quickly sort out the prospects with backlinks to be verified, and keep an eye on the links that come back with a no status, a no follow tag, or wrong anchors. For instance, the app can show you that some of your partners do have a backlink to your site, but they're using a wrong anchor, Knowing that, you may want to contact these partners again and ask them to change the backlink anchor text. Or let's say you see that some partners are no longer having backlinks to your site, and you may also want to contact them and ask to put it back or offer them something just to make them link back again to your site. If you have a project in SEO SpyGlass with a list of backlinks that your competitors have, you can import them to your LinkAssistant project too. Let me show you how to do that. Open the SpyGlass project, go to Export, choose the name for the export file, click Save, and now my backlinks have been exported to a CSV file. Then I go back to the LinkAssistant project, choose Import, find the necessary CSV file, and just follow the steps of the wizard. Hit Finish, and now we have our prospects from SEO SpyGlass added to LinkAssistant. You can also do this manually. Select and copy some backlinks in your SEO SpyGlass project. Then go back to LinkAssistant, click Add, paste the results, and click Next. Assign status and tags, select the data to update, and hit Finish. LinkAssistant is equipped with a set of customizable report templates that can be saved as HTML or PDF files and delivered to clients by various means, as an email attachment, as a shareable link, or can be uploaded directly to an FTP server. To customize a report, you need to click the Edit button. This will open up the Edit menu. The left side of the report template will show you the list of widgets that can be added to the current template. Simply click the plus button next to the widget that you want to add, and it will be added to the report template. Besides, you can edit or remove any widget. If you want to change the color, the font, or language of your report, go to the report settings, click color and font settings, choose any, click OK, save the changes, and the report will be changed immediately. Please note that white label reporting is available only for the enterprise level users. So if you are the professional user, then you can only review reports inside the software or print them out with a watermark. If you purchase an enterprise license, then you are able to quickly save these reports either in HTML or PDF format. To do that, click the Quick Save button and then select a place on a hard drive where the report should be saved. There is also an option on how you may publish your reports online. Click this Share button, and LinkAssistant will generate a shareable link that you may copy and open in your external browser. You can send this link to your clients, and they will be able to see the same report online which you have here. Well, that is all about the main LinkAssistant settings. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. As usual, if you have any questions about SEO PowerSuite or LinkAssistant in particular, if you'd like to share with us your feedback, please leave a comment under this video. Also, feel free to email us at support@link-assistant.com and join our private Facebook group for SEO PowerSuite users. See you next video. Goodbye.